Hello, Internet. This is Whispering Whim doing another Munch Pack unboxing. I had a mic issue, so I have opened the box already. There's no reason to deny you guys the first reveal here. So we've got our normal bits of paper, right? And then lots and lots of goodies that I'm excited about. This one I have opened already before I discovered that my mic was on the wrong setting. Nothing like doing ASMR and like having the gain all the way up. So anyways, this very first one is Boy Bawang Sweet Buttercorn flavor. And it's growing on me now that I've eaten a couple of them. But it's kind of a weird, it's a weird flavor. Because it's not like a corn puff, but it's definitely not as hard as like a corn nut. And it has like a lot of artificialness going on. There's like a sweet flavor and whatchamacallit, a butter flavor. It has coconut oil in it. It's just kind of a confusing mix of things. But you know, I don't hate it. It's a decent start. Next up, Al Cappino. I gotta love those kind of novelty chip names. And it sounds like it's probably from the US. Yeah. So this is made in Pittsburgh. Got a lot of fun chip companies apparently in the US. I've gotten several different brands over the course of what? I think I've been doing this for like a year now. And they don't repeat too often, so. So the flavor is called deli cheese. And somehow, it really does taste like the cheese that they put on like a sub sandwich. I don't know if that's a good thing though. Because to me, like those super like American cheese slices sometimes aren't like real cheese. You know, they're a pasteurized cheese product or something like that. So I don't know why you would intentionally make something else tastes that way. But maybe that's just me. It's definitely an accurate taste, so I'll give them credit for it being like as advertised. That's a little weird. Let's do something sweet to get that deli cheese out of my mouth. This looks colorful. Yuppo. No, I'm not even going to try to say that. Let's see here. Where are you from? It's always my favorite part. I see things that look like places. Oh, Turkey. There we go. So, usually you can't go wrong with fruit snacks, right? Well, actually you can. But I think these ones are going to be tasty. They look like they're going to be tasty. Nothing special. You know, they're not different from any other fruit snack, but They're soft and they're squishy and they're sweet and they don't taste weird, so I'm gonna call this one a win. Thank you, Yuppo. Oh man. We've got dream animals next. How special is that? Coconut flavored biscuits. I do love coconut. And I love cookies, even when they're called biscuits. And it looks like this is a product of Japan. So I usually like most of the things I get from Japan. At least I do when they're not fish flavored. So hopefully they don't make that mistake. A big old box, and I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but they have the katakana and the hiragana for different animal names, and they have English, so it's kind of an educational package, if you will. And I actually can read some of that. Ooh. Oh, and it has the English name on the cookie. That's. I don't think we have anything that's that educational in the cookie aisle. Duck. Huh. I am instantly in love with these. Oh my gosh. Polar bear. I have a definite soft spot for coconut flavored things. And these are light and crispy, and they're easy to chew, and they have words on them. This is probably going to be the winner of the day, but we'll find out. But I've really enjoyed that. Next up, we have Curly Whirly. It's a Cadbury product. And so it's from somewhere normal. Up, this is the UK Cadbury. They have a couple of different facilities in Europe, it seems. Curly Whirly. So it looks like, is that chocolate or is it? It's like flexible. Ooh, maybe it's caramel. Caramel. It's a lot to chew. I did literally bit off more than I could chew. The caramel is fabulous. It's nice and soft. I don't care for the chocolate that they have on the outside, but it's a pretty minor component. Definitely will finish my Curly Whirly later on. Moving right along, I think I'll balance out that caramel by trying this guy next. Is a cheese cracker called Cheeza. And this is another Japanese product, it looks like. Yep, product of Japan. I took a year of Japanese in college, and I'm not good enough to really read much, but I can at least recognize the symbols. It's about the only benefit I got. And I should qualify that. I know how to recognize one set of symbols. They use three different sets for writing, depending on the situation. So, I don't know them all. Definitely smells cheesy, and it has a little saver, whatever strip on there, so I can press and seal later. kind of like a tart cheesy cracker. What's the round one? Better cheddar or something like that. Kind of tastes like that. I bet you with a beer, that would be pretty fabulous. It doesn't trigger my, oh my gosh, I need to eat all of this right now. But I could easily see snacking on the whole bag. And then we've got this guy next. Another kind of Japan heavy today, but I'm not gonna complain. It's kind of my favorite place to get snacks from. And let's see here. Koshini? Koshini? Is that how I pronounce that? Sour paper. And they have a little bit of English in there. Thank you. I read somewhere that English is the most taught second language in the whole world, which doesn't surprise me, but also makes me sad that we don't teach as many other languages ourselves. So I would not call this paper. That definitely has a bit of give to it. It's like lemon flavored, but more like lemon soda versus just straight up lemon. It's not bad. I'm not in love with it, but it's not bad. I don't know if I'll finish that one. Oh, this one will be unique. Tamarind candy, artificially flavored. So that's kind of sounds scary. Not gonna lie. This is a product of Thailand. It says there are 16 tablets. So not pieces, not 16 snacks. I have 16 tablets of food. Kind of dystopian future is this? Okay, so they're individually wrapped. I can definitely appreciate that, right? It's gonna be a hard candy. I don't remember what tamarind tastes like, so this is gonna be fun. That's not bad. Nothing else tastes exactly like that, but it's kind of it's a tropical flavor, kind of within the papaya mango, slightly acidic realm. But it's got a nice earthy note to it. I like it. I'll finish these. Or throw them in the lunches. Moving right along, we're gonna go with one of the safe bets. I've had this brand before, and it's basically just like chocolate with a little cookie shell. This one has cute little love faces on it, so it's probably came out for Valentine's Day. And then Munch Pack got it as a deal, probably when the holiday ended. They're good. Can't really go wrong with a chocolate cookie. So, That's a win. Not special, but it's a win. Next up, black chocolate thunder, or black thunder chocolate. I don't know why I read that out of order. chocolate covered cocoa cookie bar. And it looks like a protein bar to me. Let's kind of look. No, it only has 2 grams of protein in it. Just pretty sad. Just that color choice. Someone needs to tell them that. That makes me think of a power bar. And then I spilt it because it's got a little broken piece. I think because my brain was already wired to like be afraid that it might taste like a protein bar, this tasted much, much better than expected. It's kind of like if you crushed up some Oreos and then dipped the whole thing in chocolate. That's what it tastes like. So, very satisfying. And this is also from Japan. All right. And that means we're already on our last product. Is it me, or do these boxes go faster and faster every time? I'm gonna have to start waiting until I have two of them so there's enough filler to make a whole video. Got a little excited there. This is CC Sick cream sandwich biscuit, lemon flavor. This is made by the Hong Kong Candy Company. So this is a Chinese cookie. You know, just to balance out our global experience here. So the quote unquote biscuit is almost savory. It almost reminds me of a Ritz. And then it has lemon filling, so I was a little confused at first. So after kind of having a bit more than one bite of the cookie, the not sweet part of it actually is really growing on me. Sometimes sugar just doesn't taste as good as it once did. I must be growing up. So this seems like a good snack that's kind of got a hint of sweet, but it's not really sweet. Yeah. So this one will be a win too. But the winner is definitely, where are you? My animal coconut language cookies. Dream animals. Super winner of the day. As always, just want to say thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope you have a wonderful evening.